So, are you guys familiar with Uber? Everybody here use Uber? All right, great. So for those of you who don't know, it's a car-sharing service that's competing with taxis in lots of major cities. Well, this week, Uber is facing some serious criticism because on Monday, their vice president of business, Emil Michael, told a group of people at a private dinner party that Uber should consider spending $1 million to hire opposition researchers to fight back against critical journalists by digging into their personal lives and their families. Which brings us to a segment we call Couple Things. So, Uber, a couple things. First thing, it's bad to dig into people's personal lives, but their families? You sound like Paulie Walnuts from The Sopranos. Then again, I think I saw a Sopranos episode once where Paulie said, remember, we don't go after their families. That's not us. Plus, what exactly is going on with the corporate culture at Uber? Earlier this year, CEO Travis Kalanick called the fact that he now gets hit on by a lot of women boober. Are you a man, or did they just spray Axe body spray into a suit until it became sentient? Second thing, to his credit, Emil Michael apologized for his comments about journalists, but he also said that those comments he made in private do not reflect his actual views. No, 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 no. That is not how it works. The comments you make in private are absolutely your actual views. That's why you make them in private. It's a comment you make in public when everyone is listening and recording what you're saying that don't reflect your actual views. That's true for all of us. The truth is always worse than what we say in public. In fact, if you publicly said you wanted to spend $1 million digging up dirt on journalists, I would have said, holy crap, Uber is murdering journalists. Third thing, speaking of journalists, you made your comments about smearing journalists with journalists around. Arianna Huffington was there. The editor of BuzzFeed was there. Sure, you later said you thought the dinner was off the record, but you can't tell a group of journalists that you're planning on going after journalists. That would be like Voldemort walking into Hogwarts and saying, hey, just so you guys know, I'm gonna burn this place to the ground. And that is off the record, Hermione. Side thing, real quick, why does your app send me a message telling me my driver's arriving when I can see on the screen that the little car icon, which I love, by the way, is still a block or two away? Maybe instead of arriving, you say something like, hey, maybe now would be a good time to walk out on the street and look for the car. I mean, that's probably not right, but anyways, you'll figure it out. Moving on. Fourth thing, Uber CEO Travis Kalanick, the boober guy, also apologized, but he did it in a series of 13 tweets on his Twitter feed. 13 tweets! Don't jam up my feed, bro! No one wants to read anything on Twitter in 13 parts. It's not a season of Mad Men. You write one tweet that says, my apology, and has a link. Because I'm not going to get all 13 parts back to back anyway. I'm going to get your first three tweets, then a fantasy football tweet, then your next two, then a sweet pick of the Biebs. And at that point, I'm not going back to your apology because I got Biebs on the brain. Final thing, I don't like that this happened to Uber. I use Uber. Sure, they price gouge. Sure, they charge up to 4 times as much when it's raining and 2 times as much when it's cloudy. But it's so much easier than taking taxis. And unlike taxi drivers, when I get into an Uber car and tell the driver I want to go to the airport, he doesn't go, ugh. Fine. Fine. This stinks for me. Whenever some company or group does something disgraceful, it's always some product I like. Uber, Chick-fil-A, the NFL. Sure, I could eat KFC while trying to hail a taxi on my way to a hockey game, but I don't want to. I do not want to. This has been A Couple Things. We'll be right back with more Late Night.